California fire. If you stay, you're dead. How a Paradise nursing home evacuated. How do you evacuate a nursing home when the deadliest wildfire in California history is bearing down and there are 91 men and women to move to safety, patients in need of walkers or wheelchairs, or confined to hospital beds, suffering from dementia, recovering from strokes? The fire is coming fast. Help is not. Staying at the Cypress Meadows Post-Acute Center in Paradise is not an option. Sheltering in place means certain death for the 30 or so staff members on hand and the patients who rely on them. A fleet of vans that might have helped ferry them to safety has been turned back because of the danger. Sheila Kraft, Director of Admissions and Marketing at Cypress Meadows, has to find 91 beds within driving distance of this small town in the Sierra foothills. And she has to find them now. On a typical day, there are waiting lists to get a bed at a skilled nursing home or memory care center or assisted living facility. This is not a typical day. The fire starts about 6:30 a.m. November 8, about 8 miles of rugged terrain away from the nursing home. Kraft sees smoke an hour later, while driving her 4 kids to school in this woodsy town where all of them were born. She spots flames in the distance as she heads to Cypress Meadows. By 7:45 a.m., she is at her desk, working the phones. I was calling every facility around, hey, we're getting evacuated, this is happening, I don't know if you've watched the news, but how many beds do you have available? Kraft said. So they'd tell me, 4 females and 2 males. Single quote, okay, I'm putting you down, I'll take them. Then I called another facility, how many beds do you have available? So, I've got one phone in this ear, calling, finding residents' homes or beds, and the other phone in this ear with my 12-year-old 7th grader standing in front of her gym with a plume of smoke, going, Mom, I have to be picked up. We're being evacuated. I'm, single quote, okay, I'm gonna get somebody to you. You stay right there. Don't move. By the time Olivia Drummond arrives at work at 8 a.m., Cypress Meadows is in full evacuation mode, a process that is fraught even for the able-bodied, gathering their own things and their own loved ones and leaving their own homes under their own steam.